I've got a bigger video in the works right now, but I wanted to make a quick one just to discuss something a bit. So I'm sure all of you have heard about this new Sora thing and, you know, just AI in general, because it's all anybody talks about these days. And for good reason. It's a huge, new, terrifying technology that is already changing the world as we know it after only existing for, what, like a year or two at this point? At least in the specific form that we currently know it, you know, image generation, video generation, that sort of stuff. But I didn't make this video to talk about the economics or the dubious ethics of AI generation tech. A ton of other people have already covered that better than I ever could. I wanted to talk about it because, you know, I'm a very small YouTube channel and I watch a few creators that are all about growing your channel, what to do, what not to do, etc. And a few of them have basically said that AI is here to stay, that AI generation is kind of a either jump on or get left behind point for YouTube. That it doesn't matter how long you've spent building up editing or filmography or art skills, some new creator will pick up an AI program and be outperforming your years of dedication within 10 hours. And they're probably right. My videos take me a very long time to make. The video essays take weeks, sometimes a month or more, because I can only work on them when I'm not, well, working. Between writing the script, making all the visuals, doing the recording, editing all together, it's a lot of work. Even the little animatics that I like to make sometimes take me a day or two. I probably could streamline it by having AI write parts of my scripts, or using AI to generate background shots, or do voice work, or any number of things that these programs can do these days. But I enjoy the process of making these videos by hand. I love drawing out the visuals. I enjoy putting down every stroke, every line, doing every silly little voice myself. Even if the final product comes out weird, I love typing out every word of the scripts until it sounds just right, or, you know, as close as I can get. I love editing and seeing a joke come together, even if it doesn't land. I love picking just the right spot to punctuate a point with an explosion, or finding just the right photograph or free stock image or whatever to use as B-roll. And then sitting back and watching through this thing that I made, how my work slowly but surely came together in this huge thing, and I can be proud that I did that. I'm sure that within the coming months, hell, maybe by the time I get this out there, there will be hundreds of new YouTube channels primarily or partially using AI tech, more than there already are. And I mean, I don't know if I can really blame them, to be honest. We live in an advertiser's world, and regular people are having AI pushed in their face as a create-your-dreams machine. The negative ethics of a new technology has never really been a big enough push for it to not be advertised on every platform across the internet. I'm sure we all recall NFTs. But, I don't know. I guess I'm just making this as a sort of letter to myself and to anyone else out there that just enjoys making things. It's a difficult time right now. People are being laid off from once stable jobs, gig work is drying up, folks are out there telling us that we're outdated or useless or wasted our lives. I don't feel I can cast blame on people who are adopting these new methods, because, I mean, times are hard. As this technology grows, so too does the sentiment that creatives are an outdated bunch. Money gets tighter, and for a lot of people, it's adapt or die. We're living in the beginning of an era where the end product is something so easily achievable that a lot of people consider the creative process, the journey to the end, nothing more than a nuisance, something to be cut out to get to the end goal faster. But even as the world changes around us, I think it's important to remember, too, that we create because we enjoy it. Because it's human. Because the process of creation, of putting our hands to clay, literal or metaphorical, and feeling it shift and shape beneath our fingers, turning something formless into something that we're proud of, is a meaningful experience in and of itself. babies smother their hands in paint and draw smears on walls because the colors make them laugh. As they grow, those smears become flowers and elephants and pictures of their family drawn on colorful paper, taped up on the fridge. Things that they like, things they care about. Kids this young don't sigh and grumble because they had to put the crayon on the paper. They scribble these images out because they enjoy it. Because these drawings matter to them. There's intent and emotion with every stroke, regardless of how visually pleasing or unpleasing the outcome. And when you enjoy something, it isn't so much the outcome that matters, I think. I think we lose sight of this enjoyment as we get older. As time becomes money and the world we live in demands us sell our passions to the highest bidder, it's easy to forget why we started creating in the first place. Creating things by hand is tedious, it's slow, it requires attempt after attempt. But through these attempts, we learn. We look at pictures of animals and fauna to understand how they move, we look at buildings and learn their history to understand why they look the way they do. It's not the end product that brings us to these new places, but the journey. Regardless of its ups and downs, it's worth continuing. It's worth creating, even when the world tells you you're a fool for doing so. A lot of people are scared right now. Scared for their future as a creative, scared of losing everything they worked for, scared to start, because why bother if a robot can do it better? But it's always worth starting. It's always worth creating. Because the journey is meaningful, more so, I think, than the end product. It helps us grow, helps us learn from our mistakes and get back up to try again, now armed with more knowledge than before. It helps us cope with difficult times and put our emotions into our artwork. And that's something that I don't personally think a type some keywords and get a video machine can replicate. If this video title didn't make it obvious, I don't plan on using these new programs to streamline my process. I'm gonna keep making these by hand because I want to. Well, you know, at least the parts I can make by hand. I don't make the music, I'm not a musician. This is off topic, maybe, but I don't really think that this channel is gonna take off, to be honest. I can't make the videos very quickly, and I'm still learning how to do proper audio, visual editing, and pretty much everything. And of course, there's so much discussion about the age of the YouTuber being at an end with all the changes that the website is making to the algorithm, the rise of shorts. It was a really bad time to start, huh? But, I think that's okay. Because I enjoy making these videos. I enjoy seeing every little piece of them come together and seeing other people enjoy the silly thing that I made. And I hope you enjoyed this one. Maybe I'll see you in the next one. And maybe I'll come across something cool that you made in the future. I hope I do. Thanks for watching.